Okay, let us go to chapter 4, energy and transformation, in the final part 7. Okay, in this we are going to see how can we use less energy for transportation. There's three important item to follow. One is how to use smarter use, and how to use transportation with smarter infrastructure and transportation with a smarter product. Okay, the first one will go to smarter product, saying it is about more efficient biofuels, but be part of any short-term answer to smarter mobility to reduce CO2 in the road transport. And CO2 in the reduce CO2 in road transport. So, for example, in Brazil, they use ethanol, is well established as transport biofuel, and by 2030, the biofuel will be up to 9% of the world transport fuel mix, up from 3% today. So, meaning to say, it will increase to use biofuel. In Malaysia also, kita ada kita ada biofuels made by kelapa sawit. Also, we can use biodiesel from minyak masak terpakai. And this minyak masak terpakai is going to be used in the diesel. Kemudian kita buat campuran tu, campuran tu akan jadi dalam about 20% of minyak masak terpakai, and then bila dicampurkan kita akan dapat biodiesel B20. Kalau kita campur 10%, kita akan dapat B10. Okay, so macam dekat Melaka, most of the petrol station, dia menggunakan minyak masak terpakai about 7%. So the biodiesel in Melaka is B7. Okay, so this biofuel and biodiesel, dia akan increase usage in the world, so that it can use, because dia akan menggunakan less CO2 emission dia punya production. And then electric vehicle, any hydrogen and gas hold promise for the future. Electric vehicle juga adalah salah satu daripada smarter product yang mungkin boleh menggunakan hydrogen untuk menghasilkan macam fuel cell, and dia akan digunakan sebagai alternative fuel, hydrogen sebagai alternative fuel. Tapi ini bukan engine, ia adalah electric vehicle. Okay, for smarter use, macam mana kita kata smarter use? Smarter driving techniques can reduce fuel consumption, keeping a constant speed. Tapi keeping a constant speed must be a RPM yang sesuai. Dia biasanya RPM tu kena middle RPM, not too low and not too high. Okay, and this will, ataupun kita buat planning routes well ahead. Maknanya kalau kita gunakan Google Map ataupun Waze, kita akan menggunakan route yang sepatutnya lah. Maknanya kita tak akan tersesat. So kalau this one is so considered as smarter use of transportation. And regularly servicing the vehicle and checking tire pressure. Ini pun salah satu daripada benda yang penting. Kalau tire pressure tu tak dibuat pemeriksaan, kita mungkin akan menggunakan tire pressure yang tak sesuai dengan tire, dan akan menyebabkan menggunakan more fuel consumption. So this is one way. Maknanya servicing, macam engine oil pun kena servis supaya rintangan kurang. Jadi kita gunakan minyak pun akan gunakan minyak yang lebih efisien. Okay, the best drivers save 24% of fuel by combining fuel economy of products with fuel efficient driving techniques. For smart infrastructure, we use warm mix road surfacing technologies that enable roads to be laid at lower temperatures. So ni apa, bagaimana nak buat jalan, so jalan pun memainkan peranan jugalah untuk save energy. So by saving energy and reducing emission, jadi penting juga untuk apa, infrastructure untuk pengangkutan itu jalan raya. And then mass transit system, traffic management, energy distribution network and city planning and virtual mobility require more collaborative work. So this one is more on traffic management and then planning supaya yalah, untuk mengelakkan traffic jam or some sort of that. Kalau benda ni dibuat dengan betul, maknanya nanti akan ada pengurangan dalam dari segi penggunaan minyak. Okay, that's all for transportation. I've shown you the importance of transportation and kita kena gunakan apa, transportation yang efficient supaya kita tak guna banyak energy dan membebaskan greenhouse gases emission. So penting, yang paling penting, antara yang paling penting selain daripada pengeluaran power plant, power plant pun banyak juga menggunakan, membebaskan greenhouse gases, tapi transportation is the second largest or second contribution untuk yang menghasil, mengeluarkan greenhouse gases emission. So okay, this is all for chapter 4. Next we go to chapter 5.